It's been a heartbreaking couple of weeks on the front lines of the opioid crisis in Edmonton. It's been 14 days since three were found dead in a park suspected of an accidental overdose. And this week, in just 2 days, Alberta Health Services saying there were over 55 opioid-related calls to EMS. Experts saying it's a spike on top of a steady rise in opioid poisonings since the beginning of the pandemic.
And it's extremely frustrating because Alberta is one of the hardest hit provinces, and we have so many Albertans dying right now.
So what exactly is behind this? One ER doctor here at the Royal Alexandra Hospital tells me what she's seen has been devastating. And when it comes to factors in this spike of accidental overdoses, she points to access to harm reduction, like supervised consumption sites, as well as a potentially potent batch of street opioids.
We are seeing situations where naloxone, which is the antidote to opioids, not working in the same way that we have come to expect it to work. So we're needing quite a bit of higher dosing.
Frustrated that as she sees more patients in the ER and hears stories of those who don't make it to hospital, the actions of provincial government could be putting up barriers to accessing harm reduction. This week announcing changes to the overdose prevention guide. Experts say it just makes more red tape.
I was a little surprised to see at the depths of the worst drug poisoning we've seen that they're introducing all this new red tape and mostly just requiring a lot more paperwork to demonstrate things that are already happening.
Specifically asking those accessing opioid treatments to show their healthcare card. While government says this is to connect with healthcare services, studies show it will deter some people from treatment.
We don't have drug checking here. Many other places in Canada, you can go and test your drugs to see what's in them. Just like basic services that are being implemented across the country are not being implemented here.
We ask the Health Minister and Associate Minister of Mental Health and Addictions what new action is being taken for this rash of overdoses. And they listed programs already announced. Edmonton's mayor calling for more immediate harm reduction, saying while he applauds the province for an increase in some addiction treatments, quote, you cannot attend rehab if you're already dead.
I just worry that ideology is getting in the way of the immediate action that's needed.
The head of the Downtown Business Association saying if the government cares about lives and livelihood, action is needed.
Be made aware of how urgent the situation is, not just from a human and a community standpoint, but also from an economic and a business standpoint.
First and foremost, we need to remember that these are people. These are Albertans, these are people, and they need help and they need safety, right?
Alberta Health Services reminding if you are using street drugs to not do it alone, always have naloxone present and know the signs of an overdose. Alberta did roll out an app, the Digital Overdose Response System, that will trigger an emergency response if someone does not respond to a timer. In Edmonton, Carly Robinson, City News.